Workstations are needed for any PC that is accessing point of sale. When configuring a workstation, you can control if the workstation has access to POS. In addition to POS workstations, the administrator, department heads, accounting, and membership personnel will need their own workstation for system setups, daily tasks, data entry, and to run reports. Use the workstation program to set up each Jonas workstation that will be accessing the Jonas system. Each workstation will need to have a unique terminal ID assigned to it. To create a new workstation, select the New button or select an existing workstation to review or make edits to it. In the General tab, give the workstation a unique terminal ID with a max of 5 characters. Use the Description field to describe either the workstation's function, for example, AP Clerk Number 1, or the person it belongs to, example, Bob's Terminal. This will help distinguish one workstation from another. This field has a max of 30 characters. Choose how you want to look up this workstation. This can be set to Network Workstation Name or by the Windows User ID. Depending on your choice, the Next field will update to Workstation Name or Windows Username. If you are configuring the terminal on the actual workstation, then you can use the workstation icon next to this field to read the Windows terminal and or currently logged in user information to fill in the field with the required information. If you are not on the actual terminal, i.e. you are setting them all up from one machine, then you will need to enter the workstation's window name or the network user who will be logging into the terminal in the field. This information needs to exactly match the Windows settings. Specify the workstation type. POS terminals are usually touchscreens. If this workstation will normally only be used by one Jonas Encore user, you can select a default user from the lookup list for a pre-filled user ID field at the login screen. For locations where several users will be accessing the workstation, select the None option. If you had chosen the touchscreen option for this workstation, you can also specify if the computer has no physical keyboard attached, so that the program will know to expect input from the screen and not a keyboard at certain points. If this workstation will be used for activity tracking, flag this field accordingly. Flagging this field will enable the Activity Tracking tab. To configure a POS workstation, switch to the Point of Sale tab. An Enable Workstation can be used for POS. In the Settings sub-tab, you can optionally set this workstation to only be used for POS. Set the workstation's defaults in the next few fields, including the default layout, sales area, and printer. Use the Sales Areas sub-tab if you want to restrict this workstation to specific sales areas. Select the Restrict Workstation to Specific Sales Areas field and use the Include fields to determine which areas the terminal can see. Use the Kiosk sub-tab to enable POS kiosk mode and configure how the workstation will act and look when POS kiosk mode is enabled. Use the Devices tab to specify any devices such as cash drawers, RFID tags, barcode scanners, etc. that will be used on this workstation. Use the Notes tab to optionally enter any notes for this workstation. Use the Time Tracker tab to indicate if this workstation does not allow Time Tracker logins, or if the workstation is a dedicated Time Tracker terminal. The Activity Tracking tab determines the workings of a check-in kiosk. The Only Use for Client Check-in field is used to lock down the self-check-in screen for the area that it is set up at. This disables access to the back office programs. You must use the Password to Exit Activity Tracking field to set a password to prevent unauthorized exiting out of the self-check-in screen. The Check-in and Member Name Display sections allow you to configure how the workstation will act and look when check-ins are performed. The Other Settings section allows you to customize the appearance of the check-in screen. Use the default monitoring area to indicate which area this workstation belongs to. Once you've completed the workstation setup, select Save. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more how-to videos, and don't forget to subscribe.